In this video, we're going to look over how to manage your files. You might already notice that there is no save button in Tinkercad. Strangely, there is no save button. While you're making and changing shapes, you need to check the status bar above the toolbar. Right after any action in Tinkercad, shortly it says saving. And then finally the message becomes all changes saved. Tinkercad unloads every file in the cloud server. As soon as Tinkercad detects any changes, it unloads your file in the cloud, so it doesn't need save button. It's automatically saved. I finalized the robot with its face. If you want to open the previous file, then you need to go to dashboard. On your laptop corner, there is colorful Tinkercad logo. If you click this logo, you will go to dashboard. In dashboard, you can find all files you have made before. When you want to start new design, click Create New Design button. If you want to edit an existing file, and click Tinker This button at the laptop corner. Tinkercad saves every file automatically in the cloud. Do you want to save your design as an image file? There is Send To button at the right end of the toolbar. You will have Send dialog box when you click it. And click Download Locally button under the picture of your design. Image as shown in the screen will be downloaded. We have went through how to download your model in image file. Since the image is captured according to your screen perspective, you need to adjust your screen well. As you can see now, if I adjust my screen like this, then the image will be captured in this way. If you want to print your model, then you need a file to print out. In that case, please click Export button next to Send To button. You can download your file in several formats such as OBJ, SDL, and SVG. Basically, SDL is widely used format for 3D print. In the dialog box, you can see everything in the design is checked. Because I didn't select anything in work plane. If I select the face shape and click Export button, you can see one more checkbox option of the selected shape, which means you can export only selected shapes. If you want to export the old shapes in the work plane, select nothing and export them. But if you have some useless shapes for practice, the exported file will include those unnecessary shapes together. I believe the best way is select the shapes you want to 3D print. Put them in a group and export this group. Now we have downloaded a STL file. When you export file, OBJ format includes model's color data. If you are planning to print in single color FDM 3D printer, aka FFF, you don't need OBJ format definitely. STL file is enough in this case. This SVG format is a bit different. Only outline of the shape sliced by the work plane will be exported in SVG file. If the shapes place above or below the work plane, you cannot export any shapes in SVG format. SVG file is for laser cutting. That means this is not 3D, but two-dimensional. You need to export file in STL if you want a 3D print.